Hey guys, welcome to our movie recap channel. Today we will be watching the movie The Man Without Gravity. So, please turn on the subtitles and spoilers ahead. At the start of the movie, we see a pregnant woman named Natalia. She is going through labor pain, and her mother is rushing her to the hospital. After reaching the hospital, the nurse informs them that there are no doctors available. So, the nurse herself tries to help deliver the baby. In the operating room, Natalia is having a hard time giving birth to her child. The nurse tries to keep her focused and helps her through the process. Finally, the child is out of Natalia's womb. But something is strange. The newborn child starts floating in the air, with it being still attached to its mother. Seeing the child float in the air, everyone is shocked. But Natalia pulls her baby to her chest and hugs it tightly. Despite this rare phenomena, Natalia seems unfazed due to her motherly love. She believes that her child is an angel. But the nurse is left speechless, and Natalia's mother's face is filled with concern and confusion. Realizing that the birth of this rare child could bring unwanted attention, Natalia and her mother head out of the hospital and go back to their house. Natalia's mother starts asking her about the father of the child. But Natalia says that she has no idea. She used to have physical relations with many men, so she didn't know who the real father of her child was. Her mother tries to tell her that the child was not normal. So, they have to keep it safe from the outside world and keep everything a secret. Next morning, when Natalia's mother wakes up, she finds that the baby is in the air, stuck to the ceiling. She wakes up Natalia and steps on a chair to bring the baby down. She starts scolding Natalia for not knowing the real father of this child. But Natalia is insistent that her baby is an angel. She names the child Oscar. Later, their neighbors arrive at their house to see the newborn baby. To keep the secret from everyone, Natalia's mother ties Oscar to his crib with a belt and tells her friends to not touch the baby, as it was very fragile. After that incident, they both realize that taking care of the baby was not going to be easy. They arrange mattresses on the ceiling to make it safe for the child to float around. They also realize that, if they ever let him out of the house, Oscar might float in the sky and reach space. So, they become very conscious of Oscar and are protective of him. Just like this, a few years go by, and Oscar is now 6 years old. And in the 6 years of his life, Oscar has never stepped out of his house. So, all that Oscar had experienced or seen in his short life was all inside his house. Even his schooling was done by his grandmother. Oscar watches a lot of superhero movies in the house, and he believes that he too is a superhero with the ability of flying. Oscar often asks his mother why he wasn't allowed to step out of the house. But he never gets the answer to it. He spends his time watching outside the house from the window. He sees kids of his age going to school and living freely outside their house. Oscar wishes that he too could live like them. He is curious to know about the life that is outside of his house. So, one day Oscar decides to see for himself. He opens the window, and when his mother and grandmother return, they are both scared to find the window open. They believe that Oscar might have opened the window and floated in the sky. But, Oscar hadn't left the house. They are relieved to find him. But, Oscar's grandmother is concerned that he might escape out of the window for real next time. So, she seals all the windows of the house and is unhappy with Oscar. Natalia, however, realizes that Oscar wants to see the outside world. She knows that keeping him locked in the house isn't the right thing. So, she fights with her mother and takes Oscar outside. She puts two heavy weights inside Oscar's jacket. The weights were keeping Oscar from floating and keeping him on the ground. Natalia's idea works as Oscar doesn't float when he steps out of the house. She also tells Oscar that he has to keep his ability a secret from everyone, just like how the superheroes keep their identity a secret. Oscar agrees to never tell anyone about his ability. One day, Oscar is out with his mother. Natalia goes inside the shop to buy something and Oscar stays outside. While waiting for his mother, Oscar bumps into a girl. The girl's name is Sophia, and she is mad at Oscar for bumping into her, which caused her to drop her belongings. She shouts at Oscar and wants him to help her carry her items. Sophia hands Oscar two water bottles and says that it's his punishment to carry those water bottles to her house. Oscar doesn't know what to do, but he follows Sophia anyway, without telling his mother. On their way, Oscar and Sophia start talking to each other. Oscar is tired having to carry two massive weights inside his jacket, along with the two water bottles. So, he takes out the weights from his jacket and leaves it. Sophia and Oscar tell each other their names and begin their friendship. They reach Sophia's house, but Oscar cannot let go of the water bottles. He knows that doing so will result in him floating in the sky. Sophia asks Oscar to hand her the water bottles, but Oscar refuses to do so. Sophia is confused to see Oscar, and she grabs the water bottles from Oscar. As soon as Sophia takes the bottles, Oscar starts to float in the air, but is thankfully saved. Sophia is shocked to see Oscar float around in the sky, and even calls him Superman. Oscar asks her for help, and Sophia quickly pulls him down and holds him. But she knows this won't work. So, she goes inside her house and returns with a pink bag filled with stones. She hands the bag to Oscar, who finally manages to stay on the ground with the help of the bag's weight. Oscar asks her to keep it a secret, and Sophia promises to him that she will not tell anyone about his secret. From there on, they become good friends. Meanwhile, Natalia is scared thinking about the disappearance of Oscar. And her mother finds the weight that was thrown by Oscar. But, Oscar soon returns to his house, and tells his mother about Sophia. Natalia is concerned that Oscar might have told her about his secret. But Oscar assures her that he didn't tell Sophia about his secret. From that day, Sophia begins to visit Oscar in his house, and Natalia too is happy to see that Oscar had made a friend. They begin playing inside the house, and Natalia even allows them to go outside to play on their own. But, Natalia soon finds out that Sophia knows about Oscar's secret. So, she stops allowing her to come see Oscar. Oscar and Sophia could no longer see each other, and the neighbors were also witnessing all of these. They believe that Oscar was imprisoned by his mother and grandmother. Soon, the police visit Natalia, and ask her about Oscar. They even warn them that they cannot keep a child locked inside the house. The police tell Natalia that they should send Oscar to the school. Next day, Natalia and her mother drive Oscar to his new school. At school, Natalia realizes that Oscar wouldn't be allowed to carry his bag all the time. She gets scared that something bad might happen to Oscar in the school. So, she takes Oscar back with her. Natalia and her mother realize that it will be hard for Oscar to survive in this environment. So, they leave their house, and live somewhere far away from everybody. Many years have gone by, and Oscar is now a grown man. Natalia is old, and her mother has passed away. Despite being older, Oscar still has the pink bag that was given to him by Sophia. He often holds the bag close to him, and thinks about Sophia and their friendship. She was the only friend he ever had. And Oscar's life hasn't changed by much. He still isn't allowed to live like a normal person. He is fed up by the daily routine of his life. He still has to carry the heavy bag when he goes outside his house, and Natalia is still protective of him. Oscar and Natalia have a great bond with each other. They both love each other. But, Natalia is aware that this is not the life that Oscar wants, but she also cannot do anything about it. One night, Oscar sees an ad for a reality show called The Extraordinary Men. Oscar believes himself to be extraordinary and starts to think that if he showcases his power in that show, people might like him, and he no longer has to hide his secret. So, he silently leaves his house, without telling his mother. Oscar soon arrives at the show, and finally presents his secret to the world, which he has been keeping for years. The show becomes an instant hit, and Natalia also ends up finding out about it. Oscar becomes famous overnight, and is approached by a person named David. He is a content agent, and he tells Oscar that he can help him become more famous, and earn more money by organizing shows and events for him. David takes Oscar to a big house, which is for him to live in. Then David asks Oscar to sign a contract, and Oscar happily signs it as he wants to be famous. Oscar is then given the nickname The Man Without Gravity. He does photo shoots and events which makes him more famous than before. Oscar seems happy with everything and has earned a lot of money as well. The media also starts covering Oscar and his childhood. They show the house that he lived in as a child. And they also present Natalia and her mother in a bad light for never letting Oscar out. Natalia is sad to see all this happen. And slowly, Oscar starts to realize that this was not what he wanted to do. He wanted to be accepted by people, live freely and be adored for his ability. He wanted to become a superhero. But he was turning out to be a circus clown, which people paid money to see. He tells David that he no longer wants to do such shows anymore. But David tells him that he has signed a contract and has to do the shows which were booked for him. Natalia comes to meet Oscar, and David takes her to him. Upon seeing his mother, Oscar isn't sure how to react. He wanted everyone to know about his powers, but now when they do, he isn't happy. Natalia asks him if everything was okay. And Oscar lies to her that everything was fine. After this, Oscar is brought to a show where he has to wear an angel costume. Natalia is also among the audience. Oscar isn't happy with what he was asked to do. And Natalia too is shocked to see how her son was being presented. Everyone in the audience starts clapping, but Oscar starts to badmouth everyone, as he is angry with his presentation. With the actions of Oscar, David isn't happy at all. But Oscar makes it clear to him that he no longer wants to do any shows or events. He wants to quit everything and doesn't want to be famous anymore. David tells Oscar that he cannot just quit everything. But, Oscar is adamant and tells David to tell everyone that the man without gravity was dead. And soon, the news comes out stating that Oscar was no longer alive. The news media starts to arrive at Natalia's house to ask her about Oscar, but she doesn't tell them anything. Few years go by, and Natalia becomes old and dies. On the other hand, Oscar was living a different life. He started acting as a wheelchair-bound person, and had grown his beard to not let anyone recognize him. He has started working at a hotel as a receptionist, and was very much loved by the people there. Even till this day, he is still carrying the bag which was given to him by Sophia. One day, a lady sees him carrying that bag, and she follows him. She calls him Oscar, who quickly denies that his name is not Oscar. But the lady introduces herself as Sophia. They both are happy to see each other, and Oscar shares his life story. He starts to become happy again in his life, with the arrival of Sophia. They're as happy as when they were children. They even have feelings for each other, and share the same bed. But one day, he sees her with an unknown man. Oscar realizes that Sophia was sleeping with other men to earn money. Next time, Oscar has a flower for Sophia, but this time too, she has brought an old man with her. Seeing this, Oscar gets sad and doesn't know what to do. Sophia also realizes that she cannot act like nothing is going on. She goes to Oscar and asks him what he wants. Oscar says that he wants them to live together, away from this place. But Sophia tells him that it isn't as easy as he thinks. It's hard to survive in this world, and she wants to live her life in comfort by earning as much money as she can. So, Oscar leaves from there without Sophia. He returns back to his childhood home, and prepares to live out the rest of his life there. Then, unexpectedly, Oscar finds Sophia at his doorsteps with a pink bag in her hands. Sophia says that she is ready to live together with him, and Oscar is happy to hear that. They start living together, and Sophia gets pregnant with their child. And Oscar starts to work at an old age facility, as a window cleaner with a Batman costume. The old people are amazed and happy to see this floating man. One of them even starts calling him out as Batman. And with this, Oscar finally realizes his dream of becoming a superhero and, more importantly, has found purpose to his life. Thanks for watching the video. Before you leave, please like this video and subscribe to the channel for more movie recaps.